and welcome back to Creeper World 3 Ark Eternal. On the last episode, we went through two previous systems, the Apex Solar System, where we met our Gork friends, I suppose, and the Cliff System, where we faced off against a Tycon station that was apparently upgraded. Either way, we move on to Andere. And move on to the last three levels of the story. Of course, we're getting close. Either way, we're moving on to Otrav. So let's begin. Getting close to that Farbor. Ooh. This world is covered with tech and none of it looks very friendly. It is tech, that is for sure. It doesn't appear to be directed toward any offensive or defensive purpose though. That is odd, since most civilizations were interested in defending themselves and the Creeper was interested in destroying them. The world has been designed to concentrate Creeper on each hilltop in sequence. That old Tycon facility in the east is projecting dual attraction fields that roll over the terrain. What purpose is there in concentrating Creeper like that? It makes it harder to destroy. This world doesn't appear configured for defense. Have anything to do with the intense signals you have detected focus on the system? Focus your scanners on a hilltop. Scanning. This is interesting and subtle. It seems that the structure on each hill is designed as a transmitter. When the Creeper pulls over each transmitter, I assume that is when each will transmit. This is where the signal in the system is coming from. Absolutely not. Well, some tiny fraction of it, perhaps. Signals in the system must be coming from billions of other worlds just like this one, all transmitting at the same time. So Loki, must be. Everything over the last 10 billion years, their campaign to destroy everything in the universe with the Creeper, has all been building to this. Scars, if all of the Creeper from across the universe is the source of the signals, it means the Creeper doesn't just destroy things. It also remembers things in exacting detail. It would only be bound by the uncertainty principle, unless going to destroy those transmitters, that field projector, and collect the shield key from this world. You must reach the next world in the system and discover what the Loki are doing. Very well. So yeah. Seems spooky. Concentrating Creeper is always a frightening thing to hear. How it concentrates is a different story, however. I'm gonna reset those to be more like this. Okay. I'm sure it'll do no harm. You have those walls there, despite everything. Of course, we do have these electromagnetic beacons of sorts, and that corrupted Tycon Forge the Creeper is seemingly using. So I have a bunch of energy to start off with, which makes me think we should build camps. Start using that up as soon as possible. Could try and get this guy. I'll try, but probably won't work. Actually, at the same time, I'm just gonna go for this as well. There's no Creeper there yet, so I should try and maximize potential there. We don't have to deal with any spores, but we are getting quite a bit of ramps. So we are getting quite a bit of energy. Whatever. Seems to be at a stalemate already. Thank you. So yeah, as we can see, it's just sort of concentrating all of that to, well, I assume transmit the signals in specific orders. Otherwise, what's the point? Of course, I can't forget our forge. Do have that siphon still. Surprisingly, we did not use any energy from that. So let's go ahead and hit it now. Should use up all the energy very quickly. Have to nullify these when these electromagnetic beacons are not over the signals or transmitters. Yeah, well, eventually we'll build those reactors up. We're built a bit too many for what that siphon was worth. These are done now. We're still in a deficit. Oh. Yeah, we're still in a deficit, pretty much. Okay. Actually, no, the reason we're in a deficit is because ammo resupply is occurring. And then once everyone gets to relatively full ammo, they can get ammo. Well, getting more consistent fashion. Stalemated it, but the issue now resides in having to somehow push forward against this. So we're building it. That's unfortunate. Okay. So, of course, I want to get the mortars. Curious as to which area we should go to first. And this one seems the most useful as ore and the totem. So get rid of this transmitter. So otherwise, we run into the issue of just not having enough energy. Gradually built. Alright, so that's concentrating on that. Should probably actually look forward while it does that, so. Let's go forward. Get some more cans just in case. It will spread out, but we have more area to deal with. Those bars are not doing great in terms of health. Concentrating again, so let's move this away. Let's build mortars on top of these mortars. Because, you know, that's typically how it goes. If two mortars is not enough, you build more. Just try and get this count on the other engines as well. We also want to get Bertha's up as soon as possible. Pretty, pretty necessary here. Clean range, almost. We're kind of avoiding Bertha's for now. They won't be as effective as I would like them to be. Funny, it's always nice to have some. Okay. Perhaps as a start. Should focus on whatever is getting concentrated at the time. Them on auto target immediately. Yeah, this is gonna be happening. Oh, actually, we're finding this bag. Goes regardless. They're down on him, unfortunately. One more wave of this, I suppose. So we can get those mortars to do more damage. Yeah, that did enough damage so that we can nullify this now. So, nullifier should survive here regardless of what happens. We'll also get a sprayer going. Meantime, we're also getting that energy efficiency upgrade because I don't want to build any more reactors. It wasn't necessary for this one because I don't have much space to deal with. Yeah, there's quite a lot of paper to deal with. Power zone? Oh, wow, there is a power zone. What? Just use this short term. On top of there. Alright, let's make this much quicker. Get this stall fire up. That you're out of the way. So another consequence, we can also get this sprayer in here to allow this stall fire fields. Should not do much. Of course, the rotors are now. now starting the fire. That is not the most ideal, but okay. I suppose I'll just be good enough regardless. So, those emitters are now on the way. Sprayers. Oops. Sprayer not being connected to sound three. Must be three. I have three earned orders, which is very nice. It's definitely very ideal. Places we don't get reach, but this pretty much decreases the total strength of the paper. Either way, we'll now make. I hope it's a super fun. Nice. Yeah, powered up with this, it'll do immense amounts of damage. Yep, that's actually beautiful. Beautiful positioning. Do some overlapping. Yeah, just taking out the signal of light for that AC for us. It's down quite a bit of space. Oh, they're just stacking on top of each other now, which is great. So they're just not doing, one of them is just not doing anything now. I guess they also magnify their efforts. Eh, I mean, I'm sure it'd be more optimal for them to not be together. It's really another one, it's not gonna do too much more. Mm-hmm. probably impact speed at this point. All the way up to 5. Get rid of these transmitters. This will be 4 at once. Oh, actually, I'll probably get this one or 2. They did take quite a bit of energy. Scheduled orders on the power zones. The birth is on its left. I'm surprised we are not limited on how many Berthas we're able to make. I suppose they do take up quite a bit of energy, but for what they do is, well, I mean, they're very good once they get powered up by a emitter's power zone that leaves behind. Travel time by like at least 80%. Of course, we're probably going to get this one. These guys aren't really doing anything. So those beacons are now turned off. Should just be able to do this now. Ooh, I'm close enough. Some of those bars are not. Sure, I'll still compile some more energy. Shield key. Alright, I'm also there. Should be down in no time. Nice. Very nice, very nice. And of course, you won the only Farbor. Supposedly the hardest level in this game when it relates to story. A lot of complaints. Anyways, let's read what Praxis and Lee have to say. At last, we have lowered the shield and gained access to this world. Leah, perform a quick scan. What are Loki up to? Scanning. I detect no Loki or other life forms. Everything here is an automated machine system. It's a massive effort. What's going on? What is being built? Give me a moment. This isn't good at all. I think I understand part of what is going on. There are automated ore harvesters here that are constructing a prism ship. That ship's sole purpose is to focus aether from a totem. Several civilizations experimented with this kind of tech, but on a much smaller scale. Our design ship has managed to create a massive prism ship. There's also a heavily altered totem in the northeast. It's covered by some protective armor as well. What good does focusing aether do? Nothing on a small scale. A on a large scale. I see now. The signals in this system are focused on this world for a reason. This is elegant beyond anything I have ever experienced. The signals present in the system are near the information capacity for this region of space. It wouldn't be possible to put more information in a volume of space bounded by a smaller surface area. The only way to get more information density is to increase the apparent surface area of space in ether as extra dimension, so that Prism ship can receive the signals being directed at the system, then pack the information into a smaller region of space than is otherwise possible. Exactly, Scars. Then what? And then it is my suspicion that it will transmit all of that information via an aether beam through the remnants of Rift space. That's the only purpose I can foresee. I do believe the results of this transmission will have one other effect. Yes. If that prism ship is allowed to launch and create an aether beam over the enhanced totem in the northeast, if that happens, the resulting aether backblast will destroy this entire star system. Well, we better not let that happen, Leah. Perhaps if we destroy the ship, it will also cripple whatever the Loki you're trying to accomplish. I wish I could concur, Scars, but based on what we saw on Otra, the amount of information in the signals, and the size of this facility, I spit out you. I believe this world is about one of perhaps millions like it. Scars, the visible universe must be covered with millions of worlds just like this one, all building prism ships to focus information and transmit it. This is all so much bigger than us, Leah. Can we ever hope to stop this? We'll start by surviving here and now. Don't destroy that prism ship, we will most certainly be destroyed. Right, Leah, tomorrow holds little promise, but today won't be our final day. I promise you that. Alright, well. Gotta destroy order processors before the prism ship launches. So, of course, those are the four corners. We have ore ships, or ore processing ships, which are gonna take ore from the mines. And attempt to consolidate that into that prism. Of course, we'll also do this. Have that command out there just to expedite building. This can be rather complicated, so I'll probably be pausing quite a bit. I need to do this properly. Just trying to get all these going. There's a bit of overbuilding in that command. That's perfectly fine. Secure as much air as possible. Get cannons going. So here come the ore ships. Of course, we do need a forge. Also, need a cannon here. Of course, one way of fixing the issue of those warships is using snipers on them, apparently. I'll use this as our research island. Doing cannons. Okay, let's get those wars closer. Thank you. spores coming in. Trying to get these nullifiers up as soon as possible, that way we don't have to deal with this creeper here. At least for too long, as the ship is at 1%. And this nullifier is powered. Alright, let's get these collectors going. Across that island while that nullifier is about to go off. That's not the most ideal. Alleviate a lot of the pressure. Now, what we'll do with this is make a reactor. Maybe some beings that we want to have as much energy as possible. Start collecting that, getting our energy efficiency and storage. Let's also try and wait for that. These are going now. We'll get one more build speed and then focus on defensive upgrades. This ready to go here. Unfortunately, we cannot put another one there. Going to fire range. Try and get these guppies out of here again. So we'll deliberately feed energy into that. So we'll clear this landing site and try to go for these orb processes from the top left to the bottom right. Two more can reach. damage now. Send in our first batch of cannons. 50%. So make more cannons as well. So we're just trying to consolidate all of our resources into one node. That way we don't have any issues. Blasters. Of course, we want to save up that sprayer ammo. Let's get all those kempies going. This ray. Sort of want to build as many cannons as possible. We're gonna have to attack Sue. It is relatively clear here where we still need to make connection there. Okay, let's say let's go for it. But yeah, let's see if those warriors there. Fill up some more just in case. Ready weapons here. No, it didn't work. Go back. Right, I need fire rate. Is okay. Still have a bit of time. I need a mortar to land first. Okay, we should have the sprayer. Okay. That's fine. Go ahead. Let's get the sprayer up there. Fight it, sprayer, fight it. Move speed, go, go, go. Gotta breach quick. Wonderful, wonderful, nice. That should be enough. Oh yeah, you can see how complicated this can be. Of course, this isn't my first time having to do this. Gotta make sure last used to die. Limited connection, so whatnot. Yeah, a lot of explosions, but it's kind of friendly. Or so you think. Let's get this other sprayer out here. close, but I don't think we're close enough. The ore processors. Get the ore processor and get a substantial. It's not fast enough, but no need to fret. It's not necessarily the end yet. Yeah, we failed. Prism ship has been completed and is launching. Nothing can stop it now. One six scars, there may yet be a sliver of hope. Scanning enhanced totem. Enhanced totem in the northeast. I think I can now set our null fires to destroy it. Wow. The enhanced totem is opening its outer guard doors, and I am able to scan its modulation frequency. It operates just like a normal totem in this regard. If you set the null fires to the same rift space modulation frequency, and they will direct the blast energy into the heart of the enhanced totem and destroy it. Exactly. Only problem is we have to do it before the prism ship docks above the enhanced totem and completes its firing sequence. So that happens, everything in the system will be destroyed. Alright, Leah, this isn't often we get a second chance, so I'll throw everything we have at the enhanced totem. Of course. It's a shame. It's very difficult to get that on time usually, so being able to try and get that nearly on the first attempt since I've done it previously is commendable, at least I would say. Either way, we can figure out what to do. And it's not like something else. Got there, we were just a bit too late. Unfortunately, our initial pushes didn't do too much because we didn't have AC to back it up. But that is a good start. Prism ship has starting its firing sequence. You have 20 minutes to nullify it, or everything in the system will be destroyed. That includes us, scuppers. I've been almost dead plenty of times, Leah. Relax and watch. But yeah, generally it's a rule of thumb here. You don't really know that there's not. There's no way still. You generally don't know that you can fail that first objective. So people try and get through it while doing that. So even I fell for it initially, where I just restarted. At least I believe I did. It's either that or I intentionally didn't care about the prism ship. Because I had some intuition about just not being probable to get to. But it is simple to get to, it just requires a bunch of well executed strategies. Either way, let's keep moving. That brief interlude. Get that fire range. Right now we're like so set up for success here that the prism ship doesn't really matter. It's a shame. I was kind of looking forward to doing that, but didn't go as planned. I was close. A bit too late. And the execution was falling off at the end there. first sequence. Let's get a powered up sniper. Those are in the way, those runners. They are swooping in the way. Those came swiftly. Maybe I'll stop that squirrel, sure. Just tapped it. Personally, I really enjoy this mission. It's a nice little tempo game. We have to act quickly in both sequences, so I don't know why people don't like it that much. Well, I do know because I've seen what suggestions were offered to fix this in future editions. That's okay. Our other sprayer. I think I've always looked at the weapons that we can use. Of course, I'm just getting some reactors going. We're not even gonna bother with the purpose here because I'm not gonna take too long to build at this point. Oh, 18% is pretty much a laughing stock number at this point. We're pretty much on its doorstep, so just get some water, some range. Supplement some more snipers. Start climbing the sprayers. I don't know what that waiting is for, but okay. Maybe if no fire gets done. Either way, let's get it going. Let's get it connected and let's obliteration. Yeah, pretty close. That's essentially what you have to do. You have to play very quickly and get those emitters, those first emitters, out of the way so that you can turn it up slightly and then have the force of some launch as an all-out attack. Hey! Incredible scars! That was a close call, Leah. Too close, but we made it. I have some other good news. I've analyzed the wreckage of this ship and I can determine where it was designed to transmit information to. She said it would send information to the remnants of Rift space. Yes, and the compressed information beam would then exit into normal space. The exit point is only one star system away from here. Ha. Platius, solely your cunningness exceeds your age. What are the odds, Leah? What are the odds we would be here at just the right place? Seems highly improbable. Either we were brought here or the Loki came here. In either case, our destiny awaits. Why not both? Prepare to warp, Leah. Prepare to warp. Pretty decent. Very, very nice. Either way, that is the end of this episode, of course. As always, if you made it this far, thank you for watching. And I will see you in the next one. Bye for now.